Welcome on board. It's a nice boat, isn't it? It's called the Dixie Queen. But if you think that you are going to see Jerome Kern's great musical showboat, you're quite wrong, absolutely wrong. And if you think you are in New Orleans, you're also wrong. No, we are right in the heart of Stockholm, one of the most beautiful cities of the world, especially during the summer. These days, I think Stockholm is even more beautiful than usually, because nowadays, these days, it's also swinging, because it's a great jazz festival going on here in Stockholm, the Stockholm Jazz and Blues Festival. There are lots of jazz celebrities here at the festival, of course. Tonight, we have the honor of presenting one of the absolutely great, a legend in his own lifetime, a wonderful band leader, tremendous drummer. Welcome, Mr. Buddy Rich. It's a great pleasure, of course, to have back in Sweden again, Mr. Pagovich. Very, very welcome.
It's my pleasure, and it's a pleasure to be back in Sweden, really. Having a great time here.
You have been here many times now.
Many times, but I think this time, with the festival going on and the audience have been really marvelous. I've had a great time. The concert tonight was exciting, and I look forward to playing here. It's very great, a great audience.
It's also a fantastic orchestra you have.
Thank you.
A lot of new guys, I've never seen them before, but they play like, well, I cannot say it because it's
this,
TV.
This band has been with me now almost 2 years. Mm-hmm. And the very young people, most of them are college graduates of music schools. And in a band like this, you learn a lot. Mm. And when they first join, for instance, I have a young trumpet player, 19 years old. His name is Greg Gisbert. And I think for the future of jazz, he's a very important force. I have a very young trombone player by the name of Tom Garling, who is also going to have a very, very great future in jazz. Mm. And most of the people in my band, I think, will keep the jazz music alive. They will become stars in their own right, I'm sure. Very proud of them.
That sounds good. And then you have old Mr. Marcus, of course.
Well, old Mr. Marcus has been with me now 12 years.
Yeah.
And I'm going to keep him with me until I understand what he's playing.
Yeah. There aren't too many big bands around nowadays.
Mm.
In 30 years or so, when you say that,
yes.
Now I'm going to ease down a bit and take it easy, but what's going to happen?
I think the young musicians who are playing jazz today and who are making an inroad, who are creating new forms of jazz, new styles of jazz, I think they will be the future band leaders who will take over when guys like Woody Herman and Maynard Ferguson and myself, when we finally decide that it's enough, I think that they will carry on the tradition. At least I hope so. And they have the ability to do it, I'm sure.
I hope so, too.
Mm-hmm.
And you have no plans at all to...
My career is just starting. I have many years to try to do the right thing. And as long as I continue to do what I consider to be dignity in jazz, and as long as there's an audience who will come out to hear us, I see no reason to retire. I have as much fun today playing as I had when I was 20 years old. And I think from the judging of the audiences that we've been having since we got here, that there'll be many more returns to your country and many more returns to the various countries that we play throughout the world. And I'm very happy doing what I do. Keeps me young.
Thank you. very proud to say he's a friend of mine, and I've known him from the beginning. Yeah. Mr. Al Gray. We get great people like that on their night off, come up and sit in and have fun. That's what jazz is all about, fun. Thank you, Al Gray.
Buddy Rich är ett fenomen, varken mer eller mindre. Han är 69 år gammal idag. Och i 67 år lite drygt, utav de här 69, har han varit professionell artist. Ganska fantastiskt. Han var stor stjärna på Broadway när han var 4 år gammal. Tjänade massor av pengar. När han var 11 bildade han sin första egna orkester och var ute och turnera. Det där med jazzmusiken, det kom lite senare faktiskt. 1938. Då blev han medlem av Joe Marsalas band. Och det var ett populärt band på den tiden, det vill jag lova. Sen kom han ganska omedelbart in bland de stora grabbarna. Det blev Bunny Berrigan, det blev Artie Shaw och det blev så småningom Tommy Dorseys band. Och i Tommy Dorseys band, där blev han kompis med Frank Sinatra. Och kombinationen Frank Sinatra, Buddy Rich, det är en kombination som håller fortfarande.
Thank you.
Efter tre år hos Tommy Dorsey så blev det kriget för Buddy Rich. Det var ju världskrig då Dorsey. Men när han kom hem igen och började musicera så startade han faktiskt ett eget storband. Det var 1946. Det var ungefär samtidigt som alla andra nådde ner sina storband. Då tyckte Buddy Rich att han skulle starta ett. Det gick nu inte något vidare bra utan det blev lite spelande med Harry James istället. Och han var tillbaka hos Tommy Dorsey. Ja, det blev både det och andra. Och så började han sjunga faktiskt. Han hotade till och med oss i Asseälskar att han skulle bli sångare på heltid och lägga av med allt trummandet. Det gjorde han nu inte, gudskelov. Han fick en hjärtinfarkt också någon gång där i slutet på 50-talet och det var ganska eländigt och vi trodde nog att nu är det kanske slut med Mr. Rich. Men då känner man inte Buddy Rich.
We'd like to feature Steve Marcus on the tenor saxophone and a beautiful arrangement of I don't know. How about Round About Midnight?
Thank you.
1966, då bildade Buddy Rich ett storband igen. Och sedan dess har han varit storbandsledare. Killarna har kommit gott i bandet. Han har fyllt på med nya, friska grabbar. Men hela tiden har han lett ett storband. Under de senaste 20 åren. Någon tanke på att lägga av trots sina 69 år. Det har han definitivt inte. Ett par hjärtinfarkter till har han fått. De har han klarat fint. Han har svart bälte i karate. Ser till att hålla fysiken på topp. Så det är nog bara på utsidan och i prästbetyget som han är 69 år. Han kan fortfarande ge hjärnet. Precis som han gör ikväll. We'll be right back.
Thank you, everybody. I love you.
This is our last night in Stockholm, and I must tell you that it's been one of the best nights that my band and I have had in the past night. We've had a great time. I must thank you all. We had a great time over at the Festival at the Park tonight. In the rain, it was beautiful. On behalf of all the guys in my band, the people who brought us over here, I thank you most sincerely. I hope that you've had a pleasant evening. I especially want to thank Al Gray for being so generous with his talent, coming up and playing with us. One of a kind. Also, I want to thank all the people connected with the boat, the chef. We had a marvelous meal downstairs.
Thank you, Mr. Rich.